It is currently the 21st of March, 2020. Right now, the coronavirus has over 270,000 confirmed cases and caused over 11,000 deaths, and the numbers are still growing as I speak. COVID-19 is an abbreviation for Coronavirus Disease 2019, which is caused by Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2, or SARS-CoV-2, but many are simply referring to it as the coronavirus. The virus has been spreading rapidly since the 31st of December 2019, when the first case was reported in Wuhan, China. In an attempt to slow down the spread and flatten the curve so that the number of cases at any point is below the capacity of our health system, many events are being cancelled, with workplaces and schools shutting down. With so much happening, I decided to make a simple Raspberry Pi powered display that continuously shows the stats and the spread of the coronavirus. I found this great online dashboard made by Johns Hopkins University that updates live and automatically gets data from a variety of sources. Now I just need a way to continuously display it. Here's where the Raspberry Pi comes in. The Raspberry Pi is a low-cost, small-form factor single-board computer that can be run for long periods of time. It is perfect for displaying something like this, so it is what we'll use in this project. I made two separate versions, one for a large display like a monitor or TV in a hallway, and also a smaller tabletop version that uses our Raspberry Pi TFT screen. Parts. To make this project, you'll need a Raspberry Pi. Any will do, but you'll need some way of connecting it to the internet, such as with Ethernet or Wi-Fi. Most newer Raspberry Pis already have built-in Wi-Fi, but even if you have an older model, such as a Raspberry Pi 2 or 1, you'll still be able to add wireless connectivity using a simple Wi-Fi dongle, such as this. You will also need a microSD card that is 8GB or larger, such as the one I have here. You may also need a SD card reader to go with it. If you're going to be making a small tabletop display, you'll also need a small TFT screen. This one also has resistive touch support, which I'll be adding later. Here's the connector for the screen. First, plug the microSD card into your computer. Make sure you have nothing important on it, as we'll be formatting it later. Next, head over to the Raspberry Pi website and go to the Downloads section. We'll be using the new Raspberry Pi imager to flash the OS onto the card. I'm using Windows, so I'll download the imager for Windows. After the download is complete, head over to the location where it was saved. Next, we need to install the Raspberry Pi imager. After the installer finishes, run the Raspberry Pi imager. Click Yes when prompted to allow it to make changes to the card. Now we need to choose the operating system to flash onto the card. There are lots of options here, but we are going to be using Raspbian, the official Raspberry Pi operating system. Now we're going to choose the SD card. Make sure to choose the right one, as it will erase whatever is on the card you choose. Finally, we select Write. After the imager is complete, unplug the microSD card and insert it into the Raspberry Pi. Now we need to plug in the HDMI cable, mouse, keyboard, and lastly the power supply. Note that your power supply must be capable of supplying 2 milliamps. Wait until it boots up, then set it up as you would normally do. Connect it to Wi-Fi. We can now restart. After you restart, open the terminal, run sudo apt-get update. When that's done, run sudo apt-get upgrade. When prompted, type Y to continue. What these two commands will do is it will update the packages that we might need to the latest versions so we do not encounter any problems. After that's done, we need to install XZooTool, which allows us to emulate key presses, and Unclutter, which allows us to hide our mouse from the display. We will install these with sudo apt-get install xdo tool and unclutter. Press Y to allow it to install. After that's done, we'll make a bash script so that the Raspberry Pi can automatically execute commands on startup. We'll do this with nano home pi kiosk dot sh, which is the bash script. As you can see, nano has opened up, and here is our file, which is currently empty. We'll full screen this so that the long lines are not cut off. Okay, first we need to add in this line. What this does is it tells the CLI how to run this script, in this case using bash. Next we need to add in these three lines. What they basically do is tell the Raspberry Pi not to blank the screen and not to show the screensaver. Now we need to add in this. Again, this will be in the description below. What it does is it will automatically hide the mouse after it's not moved for 0.5 seconds. Next, we need to add in these two lines. What they do is make Chrome think that it has not crashed, so it will not show an error message when it starts up. Now for the most important line. This runs Chrome. The first flag makes Chrome not show error dialogues, such as the one that says Chrome has crashed. The second one disables info bars, which basically stops Chrome from telling you that it's not the default browser. And the last flag tells Chrome to run in kiosk mode, which basically is full screen mode. After this, we need to add in the URL to open. If you're making this for a large monitor, use this link found in the description. If you're making this for a smaller screen, use this link, also found in the description. In my case, I'm going to be making it for a large monitor first, so I'll be using this link. Okay, that's the startup script done. Now we'll add in code so that it will refresh the page every hour. We'll do this using the following code. This code refreshes the page. After refreshing the page, we'll make the code wait 3600 seconds, which is 1 hour. And we add in done to end the while loop. There, now we have finished the batch script. Save and exit using Ctrl X and press yes to save the file. Press enter to continue. Next, we need to make Chrome start up on the right display. First, run echo display. This will tell you what displays we have. Now we need to create a service file to run this. Now we need to create a startup file to run the bash script we made earlier at startup. Do this using the following command. Okay, here's nano again. Paste in the following code. You might need to change the value here to the display ID you got earlier. After that's done, hit Ctrl X, press Y, and enter to save. Now that we have finished making the service, we need to enable it with this command. Now, to test the service, we run this command. As you can see, the display is now working. Now we can unplug the Raspberry Pi. From there, it's not too difficult to add on a small screen to make a tabletop display. Here I've got this screen. It uses HDMI to transmit the signal and gets power and transmits the touch signal via the GPIO pins. To attach the display, line up the GPIO pins with the header and push it in firmly. Now we attach the HDMI adapter to transmit the signal across. And done! Now I've got a smaller tabletop display as well. Here's the mobile version of the site for comparison. Here, the text is blown up larger so that the stats are more easily seen. To add touch, I need to execute these following commands. And voila! Now we have touch on the tabletop display. Commands I entered are all in the description below.